Once you start writing your brief, or really any long, complex document, one of the decisions you have to make is how to break up the text with headings. I'll show you the most flexible, low-maintenance way to format those headings coming up. Hi, I'm Deborah Saavedra of Legal Office Guru, your resource for legal professionals using Microsoft Office. And in today's video, I'm going to show you how to format the headings in your next brief or other long, complex document so that A, it's really easy to change them during editing, and B, you can simultaneously create the necessary elements for inserting a super simple, self-updating table of contents. The secret is in using Word's styles feature, specifically the heading styles. Heading styles can automate so many different functions, not only formatting like boldface, italics, and indenting, but also automatic numbering. And if you decide during editing that one particular level of heading needs to be formatted a little differently, you're not stuck going through the entire document and changing them one by one. All you have to do is update the style, and voila! They all change automatically. Microsoft Word gives you a total of 9 different heading styles with which to structure your document. You may find, however, that the default settings you're presented with aren't to your liking. First, let's change the default fonts. Let's go to the Design tab, click the drop-down under Fonts, and check out the default fonts. These preset configurations of heading and body fonts control the most basic font settings in Word for your current document. If any of these presets will fit the bill, then you can pick one of those. You may, however, need to set up your own. I'm going to go all the way down and click Customize Fonts to bring up the Create New Theme Fonts dialog box. As an example, if this particular court requires I use the Courier New font family, I can choose that under Heading and Body Font. Then I can save that combination for future use by naming it. Note that this only selects the font family. This doesn't have anything to do with the default size, which in my case would need to be 13 point. We'll fix that in a moment. But first, let's make sure the default font colors don't get in our way. You could go over here to Colors and switch over to Grayscale, but that could still leave some type as gray instead of black. To me, the easiest thing to do is to go over here to the Style Set and just set it to the Word 2003 defaults. One step and done. Now, I mentioned text size a moment ago. If your court requires that the text be a certain size and one you don't normally use, you'll want to alter both the normal style, which controls or cascades down to other styles, and as many of the heading styles as you plan on using. For that, you'll need to switch to the Home tab and go over to the Styles gallery. Just right-click on either the normal or one of the heading styles and choose Modify. Then in the Modify Style dialog box, either pick the font size from the drop-down or type in the value you need. While you're in the Modify Style dialog box, you can revise other settings as well. Do you want your second level headings to be underlined or italicized, single-spaced or double-spaced, centered or left-aligned or fully justified? You can alter a lot of settings within this dialog box. If there's a setting you need to tweak and you just don't see it here, just click the Format button on the bottom left and choose the correct dialog box here. For example, if you always want to put a few points of space after this heading without having to hit the Enter key twice, go to the Paragraph dialog box and make that adjustment here. If you want to embed self-updating numbering into your headings, please see my bulletproof paragraph numbering tutorials on how to create and save multi-leveled numbered headings. If you don't see all of the heading levels in your Styles gallery, don't panic. They're available, just hidden. Enable your Styles pane by clicking this little launcher arrow in the lower right-hand corner of the Styles area. Then click the Manage Styles button on the bottom right. Within the Manage Styles dialog box, you'll see all of the over 200 styles you have available. By default, Microsoft filters and sorts these styles according to their recommendations. If you want to see everything and be able to find anything, change the sort order to alphabetical, and be sure to uncheck the Show Recommended Styles Only checkbox. Now that you're seeing everything in alphabetical order, you can find all 9 of the heading styles. Within this Manage Styles dialog box, you can not only modify any style, you can also be sure that the style is visible within the Styles Gallery by checking the box next to Add to Styles Gallery. Now that you've modified your styles to fit the court's requirements and gotten them into a more accessible place, it's incredibly simple to use them. Just select the text you want to make a heading, then go into the Home tab and click the appropriate heading styles within the Styles Gallery. That's it. Or you can click that style before you start typing. It's literally that easy to apply any style. If you decide later that you want to reformat any level heading, just find that style within the Styles Gallery on the Home tab, right-click on it, choose Modify, and make whatever change necessary. All your headings within that style applied will change automatically. No more scrolling through your brief and changing them one by one. Although a lot of people I hear from actively avoid using styles, the truth is that this feature is so embedded in the way that Word works, you really can't avoid using it. Literally every piece of text you touch has one or more styles attached to it. Learning how to use styles intelligently opens up ways of working with your Word document a lot more efficiently. And if you're in the middle of preparing a brief and you're having trouble keeping up with all the court's formatting requirements, maybe I can help. I've got a brief requirements checklist you can download free that'll help you sort through your court's various rules and get all your requirements in one place for easy reference. Just check the link above or in the description below to get your free checklist today.